Hello dear friends! Ngayong araw na ito, may i-share ako sa inyo ng mga tips bago bumili ng real properties dito sa Pilipinas. I call this the 5 essential tips in buying real properties in the Philippines with a bonus tip, additional one. This is actually a basic guide for real estate damage. Let us start! Before buying real properties in the Philippines, please remember this basic due diligence guides. Huwag niyo po itong kalimutan because these guides will help buyers of real properties in the Philippines and safeguard themselves before entering in a real estate transaction. Let us start. The 5 essential tips are as follows. Number 1, know the proof of ownership. Number 2, know how to verify a land title. Number 3, know the seller. Number 4, conduct ocular inspection. Number 5, know the taxes and legal expenses. And as a bonus tip, how to know a legitimate notary public. Now, in separate lectures, we will dissect and discuss each of these vital and essential tips, so that each will become a comprehensive tip for everybody to at least safeguard them, especially the buyers, in a real estate transaction. For now, we will run down and learn the first tip in buying real property in the Philippines. On number 1, proof of ownership. It is basic that if a person sells a land or real property to you, you should have this question. What is your proof that you own the property? Kung may magbenta nga ng property sa'yo, syempre ang number 1 question mo, bigay ka naman ng patunay na ikaw yung may-ari ng property. So from your question, 2 answers may come out. Number 1, sabihin ng seller, well, meron akong land title. And number 2, I have no land title. Under the categories of land title, we have the Original Certificate of Title, OCT, the Certificate of Land Ownership Award, the CLOA, Transfer Certificate of Title, or TCT, the Condominium Certificate of Title, CCT, and under the Original Certificate of Title are the following. It may be a homestead patent, number 2, a pre-patent, and a miscellaneous sales patent. Now, if the seller says that I have no land title, but the proof of my ownership are as follows, either a deed of sale, tax declaration, or a transfer of rights document. These are the possible evidences or proof of ownership that the seller may present to you. Now, let's proceed with land title. In numerous rulings of the Supreme Court, it is held that a land title is the best proof of ownership. It is the best proof that the seller owns the property, he has the right of exclusive possession of the property, he has the right of exclusive enjoyment of the property, he has the right of recovery, and has the right to dispose or encumber. These rights, what we call the bundle of rights. Itong bundle of rights, yun po yung mga karapatan ng isang taong may-ari ng property. And including to the right of that owner is the right to dispose or encumber, which is the 5th bundle of rights. Now, the question is, yung bundle of rights na yun, are they absolute? Meaning to say, you can just do anything you want with your property without any restrictions? The answer is no. It is not absolute. It is subject to restrictions imposed by the state, by law, or private persons. Let us give an example of a restriction imposed by law. A good example will be a requirement to secure a building permit from the city engineer's office in accordance with the National Building Code before A landowner may be able to construct a house or building on his own property. Now, if you will not be able to secure any building permit, your construction may be considered as illegal by the city engineer's office and it may be demolished. Now, why then there is a need to secure a building permit? Eh, sabi mo, ako man ang may-ari ng property, I can do anything I want. And besides, this is just a house. I'm going to stay on this house. Wala namang kumaguho ito. It's my problem, not any other people's problem. Yes, but the intention of the law is actually not really to protect you, but to protect the whole community, the public at large. Otherwise, if there will be no building permit, the city engineer's office would not know whether or not it passed to the certain standards, the requirements provided for under the National Building Code, has been complied by the owner of the land. So yun ang purpose kung bakit meron tayong restrictions on such particular right. Iba yung usapan na kapag, say, you secured a building permit, but in the building permit, in the application for a building permit, your building plan shows that you want to build 9 bathrooms and 1 room, 1 master bedroom. Can you be stopped by the city engineer's office by having that kind? Eh, paano pala kung gusto mong 9 ang restroom ko, isa lang ang master bedroom? No, that is your absolute right. What the law tries to restrict is the fact that you should build this building or house in accordance or specifications laid down under the law. If there is a restriction imposed by law, then there is also a restriction imposed by private persons. A classic example regarding a restriction imposed by a private person is the deed of restrictions by a homeowners association. Remember, when you buy a property in a gated subdivision with a homeowners association, the homeowners association has its own set of rules for its governance, as well as the fact that they have made certain restrictions on the actual use of the property inside the said subdivision. It may be that the intention is only purely residential purposes. And now, your intention in buying a property is to put up a grocery store, a clinic, or a hospital. Definitely, you are not allowed to do that. It means that you are restricted by that deed of restriction. So therefore, when buying a property in a gated subdivision with homeowners association, remember always the fact that there is a restriction imposed by these homeowners association. Going back, we said land title is the best evidence of ownership. The kinds of land title that we are going to discuss are as follows. Number one, original certificate of title. Under it is the homestead patent. Number two, pre-patent. Number three, sales patent. Another kind of land title is a certificate of land ownership award, or is a CLOA. Third kind of title is a transfer certificate of title. And the fourth one is a condominium certificate of title. Now, among these titles, I highlighted the homestead patent and the CLOA, wherein each of these title comes with a 5-year prohibition and 10-year prohibition respectively. So 5-year po sa homestead patent, tapos 10-year po sa CLOA. Take note that this 5-year prohibition means that within the period of 5 years upon issuance of the title in favor of the registered owner, that particular registered owner cannot sell or dispose or encumber the said property to any person except to the government. It can only be transferred through hereditary succession. Na ito pong 5-year prohibition at saka 10-year prohibition respectively These are mandatory prohibitions. Istrikto po ang Supreme Court in the interpretation of this prohibition. So any sale made within the 5-year prohibition or 10-year prohibition, as the case may be, is considered null and void. Now, in land title, I will present to you the manual title and an e-title. If you'll notice that a manual title is, the color is orange, while an e-title, the color is blue. This manual title is actually the old kind of judicial form or title being used by the land registration authority. Technically, there are still many manual titles existing in the Philippines which has not yet been converted to e-title. That is why the land registration authority is reminding each and every owner na meron pang possession ng manual title, the orange colored one, to convert it to e-title. How do you do that? Of course, please visit the YouTube channel of Land Registration Authority. I'm sending you the link here of its YouTube video presentation, and there you will find out how to convert this manual title to an e-title and the privileges or benefits if you convert it into a e-title, including, of course, its security features. We have finished our first segment, the first essential tip in buying real property in the Philippines. I hope to catch you again during our second video presentation for the second tip. Thank you, my friends.